My dear student, have a good day. Last period we discussed the hot process for manufacture of soap. Then today we discussing about detergents, and detergents are also called as syndates. Here first we see definition of detergent. Then what is mean by detergent? Detergent is surface acting agents having cleansing action. Means detergents are also called as the surface acting agents. Then another term was syndate. Here syn syn means synthetic, and detergent means detergents. Therefore synthetic detergents are called as the syndates. Then you see the diagram. In the diagram there are the two end, one is the tail and another is the head. Here tail is the longer chain alkane, then detergent represented as RX, capital R capital X. It is considered to have head and tail structure. The tail R represents linear or slightly branched carbon chain carrying 8 to 18 carbon atoms. Here tail having carbon atom 8 to 18. Sometimes terminating attached to benzene ring. Then here tail is hydrophobic in nature, and here you see head is the hydrophilic in nature. Then hydrophilic means water loving species. Head is the hydrophilic, that is water loving species, and tail is the hydrophobic, means water insoluble or water hating. Phobic means hating, water hating is the tail. And tail is the lyophilic, that is soluble in organic solvent. It is a nonpolar, hydrophobic and insoluble in water. The head represented as X is charged water soluble and hydrophilic, so they are said to be amphipathetic. Here amphipathetic in nature means both hydrophilic as well as the hydrophobic in nature. Here head act as the hydrophilic, tail act as the hydrophobic. Therefore detergents having amphipathetic in action. Then you see the structure of this detergent. Then further we study raw material used for manufacture of detergent. There are 7 raw material used for manufacture of detergent. Then first is the soap noodles, and soap noodles, they are the sodium salt of fatty acids are called as the soap noodles. This is the first raw material used for manufacture of detergent. Then second raw material, fatty alcohol sulfates. You see here second raw material used for manufacture of detergent is the fatty alcohol sulfates. In fatty alcohol synthesized from ethylene or derived by reducing natural oil, like natural oil is the coconut oil and the tallow, etc. Then they are made by sulfonating fatty alcohol with sulfur trioxide or chlorosulfonic acid. Chlorosulfonic acid ClSO3H is called as the chlorosulfonic acid, followed by neutralization with base, that is the ammonium base, ammonium hydroxide or sodium hydroxide or magnesium hydroxide, or another base is the triethanol amine, to form fatty alcohol sulfate. Here fatty alcohol sulfate is ROSO3-H+. Then I am showing the reaction. ROH alcohol plus chlorosulfonic acid ClSO3H gives ROSO3-H++ HCl. Then this ROSO3-H+ again react with any base. I am here taking base is the NaOH. Instead of NaOH, we are also taking ammonium hydroxide or magnesium hydroxide. Then I am taking here sodium hydroxide. Therefore reaction with sodium oxide, sodium hydroxide form ROSO3-Na+. ROSO3-Na+ is the name of this compound is the sodium lauryl sulfate. Therefore, sodium lauryl sulfate is the example of detergent. Then third raw material used for manufacture of detergent is the alkyl benzene sulfonates. It is also called as the acid slurry. This is the third raw material used for manufacture of detergent. Then they are, what is meant by alkyl benzene sulfonates? They are most used raw material prepared by sulfonating alkyl benzene followed by neutralization with NaOH or caustic soda. The sulfonate group, sulfonate means SO3Na group, is attached directly to the benzene ring. Then alkyl benzene carry linear or branched alkyl group linked to the benzene. And example of this is the sodium dodecyl benzene sulfonate is the example of alkyl benzene sulfonates. Then more easily biodegradable linear alkyl benzene sulfonates, it is also called as the LAS, are prepared. They are low cost, high performance anionic surfactants available in powder and the liquid form. Their excellent foaming and cleaning properties are widely used in domestic washing. They are also used in industrial and household liquid cleaners. Then fourth raw material used in manufacture of detergent is the palm acid fatty distillate. Then short form of this palm acid fatty distillate is PFAD. PFAD, P for palm, F for fatty, A for acid and D for distillate. Therefore, palm fatty acid distillate, short form is the PFAD. It is product obtained from refining crude palm oil. Then it is a glycerol, tripalmitate, and the rest mostly glycerol, dipalmitate, monolate. The free fatty acids found are oleic, stearic, and palmitic. This is the PFAD. Then fifth raw material used for manufacture of detergent is sodium lauryl ether sulfate. Here short form of this SLS. S stands for sodium, L stands for lauryl, and S stands for sulfate. Therefore, sodium lauryl ether sulfate. Then commonly called sodium lauryl ether sulfate SLS is a very versatile surfactant. It is effective and inexpensive, used in many hand washes, shampoos, and the toothpaste. Then ammonium lauryl sulfate ALS and alkyl ethoxy sulfate AES, used in many cosmetic products for their cleaning and emulsifying properties. Then sixth raw material here, sodium alpha olefin sulfonate. It is also called as the AOS, sodium alpha olefin sulfonate. Short form of this is the AOS. Here AOS prepared by sulfonation of alkenes having a double bond at the alpha position. I am showing here alpha olefins, alpha and beta double bond is present. Therefore, these are the alpha olefins. This is structure of alpha olefin. The average length of carbon chain in alpha olefin is 14 to 16 or 14 to 18. Then general molecular formula of olefin sulfonate is R CH double bond CH CH2 N times SO3 Na. Have remarkable detergency, good wetting, and highly foaming properties. It is mainly useful in personal care products like cosmetic, shampoos, bath, and the shower products. And the last material for manufacture of detergent is the methyl ester sulfonates, MES. Short form of this methyl ester sulfonates is the MES. M stands for methyl, E stands for ester, and S stands for sulfonate. This is a methyl ether sulfonates. Then methyl ether sulfonates are anionic surfactants made by sulfonation of saturated fatty acid. Then you study saturated fatty acid. Saturated fatty acid means those acids containing carbon-carbon single bond. These are called the saturated fatty acids. Then MES, that is methyl ester sulfonates, are anionic surfactants and made by sulfonation of saturated fatty acid. Then methyl esters derived from natural oils or fat like coconut, palm, tallow or soya, etc. Then they are biodegradable and high detergency, so used in laundry detergent powders and the cakes. Then these 7 are the raw material used in the manufacture of detergent or syndates. Then further we study types of detergent. Here I am showing you chart. Detergents mainly classified into 2 types. First is the ionic detergents and another main type is the non-ionic, or it is also called as the neutral detergents. Then ionic detergents are again classified into 3 types. One is the anionic detergent, second one is the cationic detergent, and third is the jitter or ampolytic detergent. Then first we studied non-ionic or neutral detergent. Here detergent mainly classified into 2 types, ionic, non-ionic, and ionic detergents again classified into 3 types, anionic, cationic, and the jitter or the ampolytic ionic detergents. Then first we study non-ionic or neutral detergent. The non-ionic or neutral detergents, example is the first example. There are 3 examples of non-ionic detergent. First example is the ethylene oxide adex, or it is also called as the polyoxyethylene. Then non-ionic or neutral detergents, it is a group of surfactant used in uncharged but hydrophilic in nature. Hydrophilic means water loving species. As their head group does not ionize in solution, they are called as the non-ionic or non-ionogenic detergents. Then these detergents do not form salts like other ions, so they can be used in the hot water or solution containing metal ions. Hot water means this water containing more calcium and the magnesium ions. They are very effective in removing dirt and have greater dirt carrying capacity than other detergent. Then following are the examples of some non-ionic detergent. Then the first example is the ethylene oxide adduct. It is also called as the polyoxyethylene. This is the example of non-ionic or the neutral detergent. Then when ethylene oxide CH2OCH2, then 3-membered ring, when ethylene oxide add to an active hydrogen compound like fatty alcohol, that is ROH, fatty acids, fatty amides, fatty amines or fatty esters, then oils, lipids, etc., then ethylene ethoxylates obtain. The largest category of these are ethylene oxide product and the fatty alcohol and fatty phenol. Then the detergent efficiency is highest when N value ranges from 10 to 15. They are used in the laundries for washing woolen and the silk fibers. Then second example of non-ionic detergent is the alkyloamides. I am showing the here structure of alkyloamide. This is general structure of alkyloamide. They are formed by condensation of long chain fatty acids and alkyloamines. That is alkyloamines is also called as the hydroxyl amine. This is the general form of structure of alkyloamines. Then they are mixed with detergent to boost foam, so shampoos always contain alkyloamines. And the third type of the non-ionic detergent is the sugar surfactant. Then sugar surfactant are the naturally occurring sugars are used to form glycosides having surfactant activity. Then hydroxy group of sugar renders the uncharged head hydrophilic, so they are readily soluble in water, sucrose, monostearate. Then detergent are made with surfactants having sugar alcohol as head group. For example, HEGA. HEGA and MGGA. HEGA means decanil N-hydroxyethyl glucamide, and MEGA is the deconyl N-methyl glucamide. Therefore, sugar surfactants are the two, HEGA and the MEGA. These are the two sugar surfactants. Therefore, above three are the examples of non-ionic detergents or neutral detergents. Thank you for listening.